How many of you are single? Very cool. You're going to like this talk. How many of you are married? Cool. You're also going to like this talk. How many of you have had dating disasters? Come on, don't be shy. You're also going to like this talk, because this talk is about finding happiness. And finding happiness is something that concerns us all, regardless of our marital status. In Lebanon, the pressure to get married is insane and drives many of us to endure 1,001 dreadful dates and situations. My Mr. Right, or rather, Mr. Sort of Okay, I'm a realist after all, never showed up and might never show up for all I know. But that doesn't mean that I should go into a corner and weep. On the contrary, it means thinking about my experiences and uncovering the true potential of my options in life, especially since I'm surrounded by so many singles who mope around all depressed, waiting for their knight in shining armor or their princess to start the spark of happiness. Now, studies on marital status and happiness have conflicting results. Most show that married people are happier, some that singles are happier, and others still that the level of happiness is about the same for married people and singles. Now, this is because of flaws in sampling, biases, etc. I'm not going to be going into that. I do want to suggest something, though. In the studies that suggest that singles are less happy, could it be because of social pressure and the way that society discriminates against singles rather than the actual state of being single? Another thing is that in life, happiness is tied to many factors. You can be single and feel fulfilled and be surrounded by people who genuinely care. You can be married and feel lonely and isolated, and the reverse is also true. In life, there are no guarantees, and marital status does not have an impact on these uncertainties in life in any way. Another thing is that, again, regardless of our marital status, it's part of human nature to always think that the grass is greener on the other side, or that something is lacking, and that we want more. This all led me to write Beirut Knights, which is a series of short stories about real-life Lebanese dating disasters. The dating antics that the characters endure while on their quest to find the one in the hope that they will ultimately get married are many. Different guises of macho men who announce, "You will leave when I want you to leave," or karate chop you to force you to eat food in the order they want. The pharmacist who charms with a bag of pharmaceuticals on Valentine's Day, and who thinks that having a similar background is enough to sustain a relationship, regardless of fundamental differences and language barriers. Rabbit boy who's obsessed with carrots and gives long, impassioned monologues about the vegetable. Buzz Lightyear, who doesn't go to infinity and beyond, yet loves his infinity car more than anything else. The people ruled by religion and politics and itching to know where you stand. The really nice guy who happens to be gay and denial and is 1,000 times more fashionable than you'll ever be. The pervert, sex-obsessed, and horny guys who are up for some hot stuff. Ya ashta. The traditional fix-ups and the poor guys who have to contend with some women with over-the-top expectations about the dream home and lifestyle that are like something out of a fairy tale, and more. It was my dedication to the new generation that's independent and sees that life is full of options. It was also my light, fun way of making singles feel better, especially since we live in a world where so many find it so hard to believe that you can be single and happy, just as you can be married and happy or miserable, depending. And we live in a culture that constantly puts singles down and makes us feel inadequate, like we have a stamp on our head that says defective. Whenever somebody asks you what you've been up to, and you eagerly talk about your presentation at a conference or your promotion at work or other meaningful achievement, pity starts to appear in their eyes. There, poor soul. But have you met anyone yet? Some even take it a step further to remind you that you have an expiration date and, oh dear, I've long expired. And some will even tell you that your ovaries are rotting. Now, you're probably, you know, we have like many creative comments, right, that we all hear. They're boundless. Some are innocent, and they get kind of irritating over time. Why are you single? At Beirut. And this is a great one. Yalla, we want a wedding soon. Because the second you decide you want a wedding, your partner in life magically materializes out of the blue. And the list goes on. Other comments are laced with cruelty, like, what's wrong with you? What are you doing wrong? Because you naturally have to be the problem, and demographics and chance and other things simply don't factor in. Oh yes, and let's not forget the classic. I may be your age, but I'm old because I'm married and I have kids. You, on the other hand. The practice of what I call single shaming is not exclusive to Lebanon. In fact, the internet is littered with articles about how to be single and happy, kind of implying that you should naturally be miserable and in tears at this predicament. It's rather ironic considering that, according to the Census Bureau of Public Information in the US, 54% of women of marriageable age are single, and 46% of men. Now, you're probably wondering what makes being single in Lebanon unique. Well, in the West, singles are a growing percentage of the population. While they might be paid less than their married colleagues, they don't have as good of a tax break, they have to deal with some other issues and maybe silly comments, but apart from that, they can live in relative peace. And they see that it's not the end of the world. In fact, you can even have kids by adopting, by popping over to the sperm bank, or with the help of a surrogate mother. And the fact that you can be a single parent by choice shows that society is changing. And attitudes towards singles are not the way that they used to be back in, say, the 1950s. Now, this very summer in Japan, a female city assembly member was greeted by the screams of male lawmakers. Go and get married! Can't you give birth? Not exactly charming, just goes to show that negative attitudes towards singles exist everywhere. Now, in Lebanon, we seem to be pretty modern, with our fun nightlife and our party vibe beaches. But behind all this is a traditional society with traditional values. Everyone is pressured into getting married as if it's the only path in life, and people not in a relationship are greeted with scorn. It's rather perplexing considering our reality. In a country suffering from lack of job opportunities, there aren't many men of marriageable age around because of immigration. How many of you have heard about the unequal number of women to men in Lebanon? Some claim that the ratio is 5-1 amongst university graduates. While I am not going to say if that's right or wrong, because there seems to be really no consensus on what the real numbers or ratios are, there is a consensus that there are more women than men of marriageable age around. And this unique difference makes Lebanon very unique indeed. It means that meeting Mr. Right will perhaps never happen. And even if you meet Mr. Sort of Okay, Given the tough competition that abounds, many women will fall into the sidelines. Even the poor, rare, single guys who still exist are having tough times. Some are very hardworking and talented, yet can't afford to rent a one-bedroom apartment, let alone start a family. Beirut is currently the most expensive city in the Middle East, and the salaries are definitely not the best in the region. This makes marriage an elusive dream for them too, but for very different reasons. Nor have I gone into the way that some men don't even think about marriage in the first place and find it easier to never grow up like Peter Pan. Why would they want to settle down when they can have fun? Nor have I gone into the way women have different expectations today because of education and career ambitions. Many women want a genuine partner in life and aren't looking for the old traditional provider. Nor have I mentioned the intense pressure that drives many to marry for all the wrong reasons, just to have the grand wedding, only to divorce soon after. Yet we live in the land of nifrah minna kuminna, right? May we celebrate your wedding, a place with pet names for newborns that include arus bride and aris bridegroom, and expressions like irrijal law fahmi rahmi. A bridegroom made of coal is a blessing, implying that any man is better than being single. And so, a key question that we need to ask is, will our current reality signal a change in our society? Will Lebanon be more considerate towards people who will remain single for life, some by choice, but most because of sheer circumstance? Or will the community continue to make singles feel like we've missed the boat, even though the boat was never there to begin with? And so this is my idea. Happiness, companionship, and fulfillment can be found in many places. Friends, family, work, charity, travel, hobbies, the list goes on. Being single is not the worst thing that can happen. It is time we don't let society put us down. It's time we embrace the happiness that we have, regardless of our marital status. We are all citizens of the 21st century, and we can build our own paths. This is how things start, how times change. True happiness is found in ourselves, not in others. Married or happy, or single, both can be the true path to happiness, right? But remember that happiness starts with you.